defender of the faith, guardian of the terrible secret. That's it, isn't it, Doctor?
What I know of man was written long ago, set down by the greatest ape of all, our lawgiver. Cornelius, come here. Reach into my pocket. Read to him the 29th scroll. 6th verse.
Beware the beast man, for he is the devil's pawn. Alone among God's primates, he kills for sport, or lust, or greed. Yea, he will murder his brother to possess his brother's land. Let him not breed in great numbers, for he will make a desert of his home and yours. Shun him. Drive him back into his jungle lair, for he is the harbinger of death.
I found nothing in the cave to alter that conception of man, and I still live by its injunction.
Defender of the faith, guardian of the terrible secret. That's it, isn't it, Doctor?
What I know of man was written long ago, set down by the greatest ape of all, our lawgiver. Cornelius, come here. Reach into my pocket. Read to him the 29th scroll. 6th verse.
Beware the beast man, for he is the devil's pawn. Alone among God's primates, he kills for sport, or lust, or greed. Yea, he will murder his brother to possess his brother's land. Let him not breed in great numbers, for he will make a desert of his home and yours. Shun him. Drive him back into his jungle lair, for he is the harbinger of death.
I found nothing in the cave to alter that conception of man, and I still live by its injunction.
This is Job chapter 30, verses 5-8. Esau is the harbinger of death. Beware of the beast man. Job chapter 30, verse 5-8. They were driven forth from among men. They cried after them, after a thief, to dwell in the cliffs of the valleys, in the caves of the earth, and in the rocks. Among the bushes they brayed, under the nestles they were gathered together. They were children of fools, yea, children of base men. They were violent in the earth. That's you, Esau. Okay. Let's continue on. Let's go to Micah. This is Micah chapter 6, verse 12, man. Esau is the harbinger of death, man. Okay. He is the harbinger of death, man. See, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah set Esau up to be the harbinger of death on the left-hand side, man. Because Esau is nothing more than the sword of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah. This is Micah 6 and 12. For the rich man thereof are full of violence, and the inhabitants thereof have spoken lies, and their tongue is deceitful in their mouth. Let's go to Proverbs. This is Proverbs. Okay. This is Proverbs chapter 29, verse 2. The whole world is in mourning. But why? Because the base men are ruling. That's why. That will be you, Esau. This is Proverbs chapter 29, verse 2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. But when the wicked bear rule, the people mourn. So, this is why the people are mourning throughout the four corners of the earth, because the wicked bear rule. Let's continue on, man. This is Sirach, chapter 19, verse 13, better known as Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha, chapter 9, verse 13. Keep thee far from the man that have power to kill. So shall thou no doubt the fear of death, and if thou come unto him, make no fault, lest he take away thy life presently. Remember that thou goest in the midst of snares, and that thou walkest upon the battlements of the city. Now, didn't the so-called ape say this guy killed for sport? Huh? Didn't he say he killed for sport? He killed for lust? That's you, Esau. Let's read Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 13 one more time. Keep thee far from the man that had the power to kill. Who is that? He has been identified. That would be you, Esau. So shall thou no doubt the fear of death, and if thou come unto him, make no fault, okay? Lest he take away thy life presently. Remember, he kills for sport. Remember that thou goest in the midst of snares, and that thou walkest upon the battlement of the city. Now, let's go to Psalms chapter 12, verse 8. Okay. All right. Psalms chapter 12, verse 8. The wicked walk on every side when the vilest man are exalted. There you have it, man. In this society, the wicked man are exalted, man. Okay. The wicked man, the vilest man are exalted. And Job chapter 30 told you who was the vilest man. Okay. That would be you, Esau. Let's continue on the book of Psalms. This is Psalms 140, verses 4 and 5, man. Okay. This is Psalms chapter 140, verses 4 and 5. Keep me, O Lord, from the hands of the wicked. Who would that be, Esau? Preserve me from the violent man. Who's the violent man? Esau, who have proposed to overthrow my goings. The proud have hid a snare for me and cords. They have spread a net by the wayside. They have set gins for me. Salah. Let's continue on. This is Psalms 144. Okay. Psalms 144. Verses 8, then we'll jump down to verse 11. Whose mouth speak vanity, and their right hand is a right hand of falsehood. Rid me and deliver me from the hand of the strange children, whose mouth speak of vanity, and their right hand is a right hand of falsehood. And that right hand of falsehood is set up as well by Esau decrees, by Esau laws, and its policies. Let's get that as well. This is Isaiah chapter 10, verses 1. Now, I'm going to get straight to the point. Verses 1 and 2. I'm going to get straight to the point. Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees, and that right grievousness which they have prescribed to turn aside the needy from judgment, and to take away the right from the poor of my people, that widows may be their prey, and that they may rob the fatherless. Hey, man, that's you, Esau, man. Guilty as charged. Let's go to the book of Daniel, man. This is Daniel chapter 8, verse 25. Daniel chapter 8, verse 25. And through his policies also, he shall cause crafty to prosper in his hands, and he shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall destroy many. He shall also stand up against the prince of princes, but he shall be broken without hand. There you have it, man. Shalom, family.